So it's no secret that I like taking Cinnabon on little adventures. She does great, and the number one question I always get is, how the heck did you get her used to doing this? Hello, buns, and welcome back to Cinnabon Sundays, a weekly video series where we talk about all things bunny. So it's no secret that I like taking Cinnabon on little adventures. I do it on our vlogs, I do it on our Instagram, I post about it a decent amount, and the number one question I always get is, how the heck did you get her used to doing this? Throughout my videos, I've kind of touched on a few tips, but I figured it would be nice just to do one designated video about how I got Cinnabon to the point where I can take her on adventures and just what I do when we go out. So if that's something you're interested in, go ahead and give this video a big like. And if you're new to our channel, subscribe because we post videos every single Sunday. Before we get into our tips, I do want to add a disclaimer to this video, which is something I share a lot, that is, every single bunny is different. Traditionally, rabbits are much more shy, they're prey animals, so they're just much more wary of the world around them. However, they are very adaptable. But every rabbit's level of adaptability is different. So some rabbits are gonna be way more adaptable than others. Taking rabbits out of their routine is inherently stressful on them. If you do proper training and your bunny is very, very adaptable, it can end up being quite fine and kind of an enjoyable experience for them. However, if you have a rabbit that's pre-exposed to trauma, like if you adopted it and they came from a rough home, or if you have a rabbit that you just know is extremely skittish, this might not be for you, and that is okay. There are so many wonderful things you can do in your home with your rabbit, but if you know that your bunny is a little more adaptable and you're down to try it out, go for it. So now that that disclaimer is out of the way, let's talk about how to do it and how to see if your rabbit is capable of being a little adventure bun. Now the first thing you're gonna need is a carrier. Now I have a traditional carrier that I use for long car rides, that I use to go to the vet or just travel in general, and that's great, but it's not what I wanna use to take her out and about on the town. I have this carrier that I'm obsessed with that I got on Amazon. It's pretty inexpensive. She can poke her little head out, but the hole is small enough where she can't like push her whole body through, and I have loved it. But you can even search on Amazon just for carrier purse, and there are so many options, especially if you don't feel comfortable with their head sticking out. There are some where you can unzip a top and they can poke their head out, but if you're nervous, you can zip it completely closed. So for smaller outings, I recommend getting something like that. It's easy, it's casual, and it's cute too. Now, when I go on these outings, I really don't bring much. Now don't get me wrong, when I first started, I was like, I need the hay, I need syringes of water, I need everything I could possibly need. But in actuality, I'm not taking Cinnabon out for hours. I'm taking her out for like one, maybe 2 hours max, and she is going to be okay in that time. If you're really worried, you can pack a little bag of treats, maybe even a little bag of hay, but if I'm doing a quick outing, I don't bring anything. But one thing that I do make sure to add is a pee pad. Now Cinnabon is potty trained and she's awesome with her potty habits, but sometimes she can get nervous, or I might grab her before she's gone to the restroom and she doesn't want to hold it the whole time. So I line my little purse thing with a pee pad, so that way if she does have to relieve herself, it's easy cleanup, it doesn't get all over her, and it's just an easy thing to get rid of. So now that our carrier is all packed, let's talk about how to get your rabbit used to going on these outings. Practice makes perfect. When it comes to desensitizing your rabbit, the more you can add it into their routine, the less scary it's going to be. When I got Cinnabon, I knew that she was going to be a rabbit that I would take places. At the time, I was living in DC and I knew I'd be traveling back to North Carolina a lot. Also, I knew I wanted to try and get her to be more adaptable to going out in the world. So pretty early on, I'm talking like 3 or 4 months of age, I would put her in her carrier and I would take her with me just to go pick up breakfast or my coffee. It was a 5-minute drive. I would have my boyfriend drive so I could hold the carrier and watch her during the time. We'd go get our coffee, come home, and I would immediately reward her with a treat to say, hey, if you did this, that means you get a reward. And also for me, her accepting a treat tells me that she's okay. If she's willing to eat, that means that she's not overly stressed out and panicked. Now, if you are in the car and you can see like the whites of your rabbit's eyes, their nostrils are flaring like crazy, and you get home and they refuse to eat or drink or anything, that's usually a sign that your rabbit is terrified, and I would suggest not really doing that too often. So that's really where your intuition and your knowledge of your rabbit's personality comes in. But I will say, every once in a while, you're gonna need to put your rabbit in the car to take them to the vet. So it is good to give them that practice every once in a while. If it is really traumatizing for your bunny, I wouldn't make it a habit. I would just make it something that you do to keep up that like skill of being in the car. Does that make sense? So after a couple of the shorter trips with Cinnabon, I'm talking like the 5-10 minute trips, I would start bringing her on things that were really chill. Like I remember I went on a picnic once. Those were really nice because it wasn't super hectic. She could kind of see a new place, but it wasn't just like an overwhelming experience. And like everything else, practice makes perfect. Just keep adding a little bit more time, maybe try out something new. Always monitor your bunny, always offer them a treat when you get home, see how they're doing, and the more you do it, the more comfortable they're gonna be with these things. Now I can take Cinnabon out and we can either pick up some food, I take her to stores that are pet friendly, and she'll look around, poke her head. It's not her favorite thing in the world, however, she stays very calm, she always eats, poops, and drinks as soon as we get home, and I can tell that she is not overly stressed out in those environments. One more thing that I do want to note is that it really is important that you check to make sure wherever you're bringing your rabbit is pet friendly. I never take Cinnabon anywhere where she is not welcome. I want to respect the store because there are a lot of reasons a place could be not pet friendly. If she's welcome, I will bring her in and it is fine, but if she is not, I do not take her, I do not risk it, and I want to respect the policies put in place. And that's really about it. It's not rocket science, it's not crazy, but it is something I get asked about a lot, and it's something that's not super normal. Always put your rabbit and their feelings first. If they seem extremely uncomfortable, extremely scared, don't do this to them. It's not right. But if you have a rabbit that's like Cinnabon and is more adventurous and more adaptable, go for it, try it. It's a really fun bonding experience, and it's nice for other people in the world to be like, oh, rabbits don't just live in cages. They can come out in the world like dogs can too. And those are our tips. Comment down below the name of your bunny and how long you've had them, because I just love getting to know y'all and getting to know about all of your beautiful little buns. And if you don't have a bunny, who cares? Happy to have you here, happy to share some information. That is all from us. We will see you next Sunday for another video. Bye, buns.